G'day everyone. A few weeks ago I did a video where I did some inverted orbits around a light pole and some rolling orbits, and there was a few comments asking how to do it. So I thought I would record a little tutorial video here. I'll be using just this 85mm 2S Whoop to get the job done. And yeah, I just wanted to go through some of the basics of inverted orbits, but then rolling orbits seems to be the thing that people struggle to get their head around, because when you look at them, it's sort of almost as if the quad's flying upside down and rolling around the pole. And to be honest, I haven't looked at the stick overlay yet to find out exactly what I'm doing to do a rolling orbit, and there might be other trick tutorials around, but this is sort of an answer to some people asking the question in my previous video, so here we go. First of all, inverted orbit. So inverted orbit's just like a normal orbit. You got your object and you're yawing and rolling and pitching forward to go around the object. An inverted orbit isn't really inverted. It's actually that you're just facing the quad outwards as you do the orbit. It's the exact same stick movement, but you're looking out the top of your camera's field of view instead of looking out the bottom to stay aligned. So basically, you're going to need more angle normally to be able to actually see the object that you're going around, which is why on this one I've sort of set the cam angle pretty high, like 35 degrees, but you can do it with a lower angle if you've got a wider field of view. But basically, it's the same stick movements as a normal orbit, but just you spin around. I think the coolest way to start the trick and to go into it is actually to do it from a Matty flip. So I'll show you on this one. I'll flip over the top of the light pole, and as I'm coming down underneath looking up at the pole, that's when I just start adding roll and yaw, and then you start going around the object. So let's have a go at that now. All right, let's give this a go. So we'll just start with inverted orbits, and as I said, I like to start them off with a Matty flip. I actually think it's a pretty easy way to get it started if you're fairly confident with Matty flips, but now let's have a look here. So you just approach the object that you want to flip over, pitch forward, and then start adding roll and a bit of opposite yaw to keep everything aligned. Then we can bump the throttle up if you want to go up higher, and cut the throttle a little bit, drop back down. You add a little bit of extra yaw, and you can do a full rotation. Let's do that again, drop from the other side and maybe go in the opposite direction this time. Not sure if I can do it this way. So we go for a Matty flip, and rolling towards the object. So just keeping it at the top of field of view, you can add a little bit of extra roll to push it into the center again, and pushing back up. So because this is so heavy on batteries, I might bring it down before I start the rolling orbit part. But yeah, so you can see there's not a lot of stick movement once you get it going. It's just maintaining sort of roll and yaw. And we can spin it back the other way. Oh, I'm about to run out of battery. It'll probably brown out if I don't land soon. Let's bring it in. I think one of the things that gets people with this one a little bit is the only difference with this when you compared to facing forward in an orbit is if you want to move towards the object, you have to pitch back and add throttle. We're so used to, when we pitch forward, adding throttle, you have to sort of reverse that when you're doing these inverted tricks, where you pitch back to get closer and to move faster, but you add throttle. And then likewise, if you want to slow it down and move further out, you have to pitch forward and reduce throttle, otherwise you'll shoot up in the air. All right, now rolling orbit. Let's see how we go. All right, so I might just enter a bit more normally for this one. Try to sort of just roll into the orbit. All right, so once you get locked in, Now I'm going to start adding extra yaw. And just correcting with pitch. Whoa, we got pretty close there. Now let's try that again. So we'll roll in. Get the inverted orbit going. All right, we're looking up, looking good. Hey. All right, let's try that going the other way, shall we? All right, so we're orbiting. And we just want to add a bit of extra yaw. And add a bit of extra yaw. Add a bit of extra yaw. So it's sort of like a yaw spin. You're rolling around going from a normal orbit to an inverted orbit by just yawing too much. Yeah, I think I don't know how else to explain it other than that. I think that makes sense. Because as we said, an inverted orbit is just a normal orbit, but you're looking up. So you're essentially just yawing around on the spot. Ah, that's what's messing me up. It's windy. It's almost pushing me into the pole from the wind. Really account for that. Yeah. So yeah, there it is. I hope that helps. So it looks like, yeah, the rolling orbits are essentially normal orbit, inverted orbit, whatever, but you just add extra yaw. And that sort of spins the quad around. I'll grab it from outside. So, you're going around the object, but you're also just yawing extra. And then you use your pitch and your roll to keep yourself moving around the object. I think I've done better rolling orbits before, but I think that pretty much shows you how to do it. And now, just for the sake of it, I'm going to do some freestyle with the stick overlay. Sorry if it's a bit noisy, I've got the air conditioner on. It is too hot to be flying without air conditioning. Sketchy reception there. Oh yeah, it is windy. And whoops do not like wind. I'm not even sure which direction the wind's going, which makes it extra hard. Can't really account for it. Yeah, it's pretty relaxing. The great thing about freestyling these like 85mm whoops is I really don't care if someone rocks up. Like there's a dog walker here and it's pretty quiet and I'm not gonna hurt anyone with it. So that's nice. The only downside is I'm almost out of battery already. As you can see. Whoa, almost got stuck in a tree. Fun times. So yeah, hope that was helpful. Let me know in the comments if you want to see any other tricks. It's pretty easy now that we've got the stick overlay in Betaflight for me to just sort of crop in to show what the sticks are doing. Otherwise, have a great new year, and I'll catch you around.